You look very Hawaiian.
Thank you.
And I just got off the set of the Lost in Atlantis.
Yes.
Part of this movie.
Yeah.
Not a bad place to do a little movie.
Yeah, definitely no complaints. It's so stunning. I mean, I remember that set, I was just like running up and down the mountains, like singing and prancing and frolicking. I'm good at frolicking, I think.
Okay, well, does that kind of move, knowing that you were gonna shoot here, did that make you want to do this more? I mean, do you kind of say, okay, this is where it's going to shoot, and then I'll look at the script later?
I mean, I heard about the cast, and that was such an amazing draw. And then filming in Hawaii, I was like, that's kind of win-win, you know?
Mm-hmm. Now, here's a movie. We've actually got three generations of men. We've got the grandfather, father, son. Then you have your character and your father, and I mean, you're like the straight man to Luis Guzman.
Yeah, I wear the pants in mine and my father's relationship. Luis Guzman is hysterical. He's such a crack up, he's such a riot, and he's so random. Sometimes the things that come out of his mouth, I'm like, I have no idea where this man thinks of these things. But he's so much fun and our relationship is so sweet. I mean, it's definitely one of those things where Kailani thinks that he's embarrassing. And of course, all kids go through a time where parents are the most embarrassing things and they want nothing to do with them. But if you step back, you realize that you'd be nowhere without them. And you love them so much and they love you just as much, if not more.
Well, it's an interesting dynamic between the two of you. I don't know how you kept a straight face because he said so much of his stuff was ad-libbing.
Yes, it truly was. I mean, he would come up with stuff that was even funnier than the actual lines, and then he'd make up completely different side stories that weren't even on the page, like him and Dwayne. Like, he made their own little story, and Dwayne was just there to play along.
Let's talk about Dwayne. Had you met him before?
I have, yes.
Okay, yeah. And working with him?
He's awesome. I mean, like, he's so driven, man. This guy has like a schedule and he sticks to it. Like, if our call time was 6, he would wake up at 4 to work out. So I was constantly impressed by that, by his skills, like playing the ukulele and singing. I did not expect such a big guy to have such a sweet voice.
He didn't ask you for some tips, maybe?
Nah, he did his thing. Yeah, got to it.
Okay, and then Josh. Now, you know this, he's got a big year coming up.
Yeah.
Doing Hunger Games and so on. So you caught him sort of right, maybe in the middle of his success?
Yeah, I don't know. I mean, like, he's a great kid. He is one of my best friends, and we just have so much fun together. So I'm excited for him. I think that he's doing really well. He has been doing this for a long time, so he's kind of a vet in his own right.
And then, of course, your characters, you had to kind of hold him back.
Yes, in the beginning of the movie, Kailani wants absolutely nothing to do with Sean. But slowly throughout the adventure that she gets taken on against her will, she gets her eyes opened up to the adventure and mystery and slowly falls for Sean because it's a great gift. And
right.
He saves her too, so.
That's true.
Yep, he's her hero.
And what about Michael Caine?
Michael Caine, he's amazing. I mean, he's a legend. He's legendary, and everything that he does is so epic. But, I mean, showing up to work every day and seeing the enthusiasm that he has that matches mine was really refreshing and inspiring. He doesn't need to be doing this, but he loves it so much that he continues to.
He seemed to have fun. I could see how he
liked. He has so much fun. He's the best time. I had the best time with him. I mean, listening to his stories that he would be talking about and, like, singing. He loves his pop culture. I mean, just everything about him was awesome.
Did you sing with Sir Michael?
Oh, almost every day.
What'd you guys sing?
Fireworks, Katy Perry, Beyonce. I mean, whatever.
That's so cool.
Yeah.
I mean, that's amazing.
Yeah, he's
awesome. Did you get any of that just for your own personal video?
No, I mean, it's all right here.
Okay, that's even better. But as I'm sitting here talking to you about the male characters, you're the only girl in the movie.
Yeah.
Nice.
I know.
Did you feel like that on the set? You got the male director and all these guys? What was...
I mean, I've always been like the Lone Ranger when it comes to being a girl. I've always been one of the guys, I think of myself. So, I don't know, it felt right. It was just so much fun.
So what about a sequel? Because there's talk that there's, you know, that maybe in the works.
Yeah, I mean, I know nothing, but I wouldn't mind it. It's a fun cast.
So what have you got coming up now?
A lot. I'm about to start a movie called Spring Breakers. Harmony Korine is directing it. It's I play a college girl stuck in a small town with her three best friends, and they end up on vacation on spring break and end up dominating in a very empowered and violent way. So it's a lot of fun. It's gonna be wild.
What, Thelma, Louise, Bridget, and Mary.
Kind of. I mean, yeah, in this case, I'll be working with Selena Gomez. So,
oh, nice.
I'm excited to be able to go to unknown territory with her.
Okay, yeah. So that's coming up.
Yes.
Okay, so, I mean, do you get a little time off?
No, not yet. I mean, I'm traveling. I'm doing what I'm passionate about, so no complaints.
Okay, so what do people now, when they see you on the streets, do they, are they still talking about High School Musical, or do they talk about Sucker Punch, or they, you know, we're growing up with you, Vanessa.
No. Yeah, I mean, every now and then I'll get, like, a Beastly, or a Band Slam, or a Sucker Punch, but for the most part, it's High School Musical, so I'm excited to see what the fans are going to think about what I have coming out next, because I feel like that image that they have is definitely going to be shattered a bit.
But isn't it time? I mean, you've got to be a grown-up now.
Yeah, I mean, I don't have to be a grown-up. I don't think I'll ever officially be a grown-up. I'm always a kid at heart, but I want to do everything. So this is just a step in the right direction.
Directing?
I want to play every character and do all different genres. Maybe directing, but right now I have such an actor's mentality, I feel.
All right. Well, you're learning still. I mean, yeah. It's always, but I hope you've got to learn every day.
Yeah, every day.
And what about singing? Are you still doing the music thing?
No. I'm just focusing on film right now. I have, like, everybody in my life almost is a musician, so I'm constantly surrounded by it, but it's just not what I find myself focusing all my time and effort on.
Well, and I mean, how many people can say they sing with Sir Michael Caine?
Not many.
I mean, so I think that's great. Well, you look absolutely stunning. You
awesome.
You belong in this, on this island. You really do.
I think I do too.
Okay.
Maybe I'll just move.
Well, okay.
Where's Vanessa?
First.
Hawaii.
That wouldn't. There could be worse, right?
Yeah.